بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم رب اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی. Good day everyone, Salman here again, and today the topic of our this session is hydrogen sulfide. Hydrogen sulfide is a very toxic gas, and today I will give you few information about hydrogen sulfide, which will include what is hydrogen sulfide, how hydrogen sulfide is formed, and what are the sources where hydrogen sulfide is formed, how many names people give to hydrogen sulfide, what are the characteristics and properties, physical and chemical properties of hydrogen sulfide, then what are the effects which hydrogen sulfide produce on our body, then what will be the emergency response procedure we have to follow once we listen hydrogen sulfide alarm, and in the last first aid procedures if you exposed to hydrogen sulfide, what you need to do. So hydrogen sulfide, it's a combination of two elements, hydrogen and sulfur, two elements of hydrogen and one atom of sulfur. When they combine, we call this one as hydrogen sulfide. You must need to remember that it is the second most toxic gas in the world. It is 5 times more toxic than carbon monoxide. So how this toxic gas is formed? So H2S is produced primarily through the decomposition of organic material. For example, when these animals and plants, they died, they buried, and they start rotten, in the low concentration of oxygen, hydrogen sulfide is formed. In industrial sources, hydrogen sulfide is a product, byproduct, or a waste material. So in a lab also, when we mix acid plus sulfur compounds, hydrogen sulfide is formed. So there are different sources where we can get hydrogen sulfide. For example, hydrogen sulfide is found in oil and gas production and refining process. In sour natural gas, hydrogen sulfide is there, in chemical plants, in underground minings, produced water means whenever we drill this oil and gas, this water also come from there, and this water contain hydrogen sulfide. We call this one as produced water. It is also present in a stagnant water. It's also present in a stagnant water and is sewage produced by human and animal waste, and it accumulates in confined spaces in the facilities where we handle hydrogen sulfide. There are so many names people give to hydrogen sulfide. People call this one as sour gas, sewer gas, rotten egg gas, stink damp. Then people call this one as a silent killer. So whatever the names are there, if somebody calls you calls in front of you, it's a sour gas, it's a rotten egg gas, it's acid gas, we call this one as, this is hydrogen sulfide. It's the most common name, hydrogen sulfide. So there are different properties and characteristics, and one should know what are the properties and characteristics, because the more you understand hydrogen sulfide properties and characteristics, the more you will be aware that how you need to save yourself from hydrogen sulfide exposure. The first thing is, hydrogen sulfide is a very toxic gas. It can kill you. How it can kill you? It will attack on your nervous system. Once it attacks on your nervous system, the communication which is going from your brain to your body organs, it becomes weak, and you stop breathing, your heart stop pumping the blood in all over your body, and within a few minutes you will be no more. Second thing is, hydrogen sulfide is a colorless gas. You cannot see hydrogen sulfide with your naked eye. It's a colorless gas, but in some presentations you can see people use a green color, but this is just for a demo or to explain you. So actually it's a colorless gas. Hydrogen sulfide has a smell, a particular smell of rotten eggs, but interestingly you can smell this rotten egg only, this smell, once the concentration of hydrogen sulfide is below 1 ppm. You can smell hydrogen sulfide below 1 ppm as a rotten egg gas. Once you stay in an area where hydrogen sulfide is there more than 100 parts per million, you must remember it is an ideal immediate danger of life and death, IDLH. And at 100 parts per million, hydrogen sulfide will paralyze your sense of smell for a short period of time. Hydrogen sulfide is a heavier gas. It is heavier than air, so normally it goes at the low-lying areas. Hydrogen sulfide is dispersed with wind. It can move with the wind, so we must need to take proper wind direction, crosswind and above the wind. Okay. Hydrogen sulfide is a very corrosive gas. It is soluble in oil and water. The auto ignition temperature of hydrogen sulfide is 260 degrees Celsius. We must need to know that hydrogen sulfide, whenever we burn hydrogen sulfide, it burns with a blue color flame. It produces another toxic gas. I repeat, whenever we burn hydrogen sulfide, it burns in a blue color. It produces another toxic gas. We call this one as sulfur dioxide. And the lower explosive limit and upper explosive limit. This is very important, and we must need to understand what is the lower explosive limit of hydrogen sulfide. So the lower explosive limit of hydrogen sulfide is 4.3% and the upper explosive limit of hydrogen sulfide is 46%. So let me tell you about the how we measure hydrogen sulfide. We measure hydrogen sulfide in parts per million, in ppm, parts per million. For example, if in any area we call hydrogen sulfide concentration is 1%, 1% will be equal to 10,000 parts per million. If it is 0.1%, it means it is 1,000 parts per million, and it is very, very lethal. And it is the concentration would be 0.001%, it is 100 parts per million, IDLH, immediate dangerous to your life and health. You are not allowed to remove your mask even for a few seconds. So you must save yourself. 0.001% means 10 parts per million, and 0.0001% means 1 part per million. And I repeat again, below 1 part per million, you can smell hydrogen sulfide as a rotten gas. If you're working in an area and hydrogen sulfide is released there, at 10 ppm you can feel irritation in your eyes. At 30 ppm you can feel irritation in your eyes, in your nose, in your throat. 100 parts per million, it will paralyze your sense of smell for a shorter period of time. At 300 parts per million, you will feel severe irritation in your respiratory tract, like inflammation effects will be there. 500 parts per million, if you stay in the area more than 30 minutes, you will feel abdominal pains and you can be fainted, you can be unconscious. At 700 parts per million, you can immediately unconscious, and if you would not rescue immediately, you would be die there. At 1000 parts per million, at 1000 parts per million, if you take a deep breath, you will be no more. If people will take you to the safe area, to the fresh area, you will be no more. So only 1000 parts per million, it would be very, very dangerous. We need to know that there are a few effects which hydrogen sulfide posted on you. We call this one as what is the duration, what is the intensity, the frequency, and individual susceptibility. It requires a lot of detail which I cannot explain in a shorter video. Exposure limits. The threshold limit value 10 ppm. If you want to work in an area where hydrogen sulfide concentration is 10 ppm, 10 parts per million, you can work there 8 hours a day, 5 days a week. So total 40 hours in a week you can work. This is I'm telling you without a breathing device. If we call this one as long-term exposure limit, a short-term exposure limit STEL. If the concentration of hydrogen sulfide in the area is 15 parts per million, you can work inside the area for 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, you have to go outside the area, stay 1 hour in outside the area in the fresh area. Then you can come back again, work for 15 minutes, then again stay outside 1 hour, then come back for the third time for 15 minutes work, then go outside for the area for 1 hour, again in the last time. When you work 15 minutes, it means 15, 15, 15 and 15. Overall, you spend 1 hour. So now your today's limit for hydrogen sulfide exposure is over. Now you are not allowed to go again inside the area, otherwise adverse health effects will be there on your body. And 100 parts per million, as I told you before, immediate danger to your life and health. Now comes the emergency response. If you are working in an area where hydrogen sulfide is there, if it is leaked, how can we know? We can know by detectors. There are different type of detectors in the area. For example, you have your personal gas detectors, which can give you the first alarm at 10 ppm and the second alarm at 15 ppm. We have multi-gas detector, where authorized gas tester is allowed to take the multi-gas detector and check the area and check the concentration of hydrogen sulfide. Then we have fixed detector in the area, bottom at the bottom area, floor of the area, because hydrogen sulfide is heavier, so whenever it releases, it goes at the low-lying areas. Then we have remote or wireless gas detectors. So once these detectors are there and hydrogen sulfide is released, what we need to do? Once we listen the alarm, what the first thing you need to do? Do not panic. Once you're working in the area, you listen hydrogen sulfide alarm. Remember again, do not panic. Hold your breath. In such areas, you have to have your emergency life support apparatus, a small cylinder having a mass, and the capacity would be for 15 minutes. 15 minutes here is there. So once you listen the alarm, don't panic, hold your breath, take out the mask, wear your mask, check the wind direction. Always check the wind direction whenever you are working with hydrogen sulfide. Now you need to move crosswind and above the wind. Okay, crosswind and above the wind. This is the way you need to go to the assembly point area. And in some, if you are working in an offshore area, you have to go to the helipad area. Remember this thing again. Okay, now if you are working with hydrogen sulfide and, for example, a solution of hydrogen sulfide drops on you, what you need to do? You need to go to immediately to the emergency shower. Switch on the shower and stay there and decontaminate all your body. Okay, somebody can help you so you can easily decon yourself. Or if your eye is exposed to hydrogen sulfide, just go to the emergency eye washer, and you need to open your eyelids continuously for 15 minutes. So continuously you need to wash your eyes for 15 minutes and go and seek the medical attention. So these are few information which I can give you in this shorter video about hydrogen sulfide. You have to understand the properties and characteristics of hydrogen sulfide to save yourself, to save your bodies. Remember this thing. So if you need a detailed presentation, if you need a detailed training, normally we have a 1-day training, we have a 2-day training with self-contained breathing apparatus. You can contact with me at salmanarashid@gmail.com. So thank you very much. See you again. Bye-bye.